Hi, today we are going to learn about changing equations to standard form another method. Let's look at a problem. Write the equation in standard form. X square plus y square plus 12x plus 8y plus 36 equals 0. Now we will use the completing the whole square method in order to write these equations in the standard form. So I'll club the x terms and y terms together. So I can say x square plus 12x plus y square plus 8y plus 36 equals 0. Now in order to complete the square, I'll take the coefficient of x term, divide it by 2 and square it. Similarly, take the coefficient of y term, divide it by 2 and square it. So 12 by 2 is 6 and 6 square is 36 for x, and for y it's 8 by 2, that's 4, and squared is 16. So we will add and subtract this term. So we can say x square plus 12x plus 36 plus y square plus 8y plus 16. And in order to balance this equation, we will subtract this, minus 36 minus 16. So now, this becomes a plus b whole square formula. A plus b squared is given by a square plus 2ab plus b squared. So this is x plus 6 whole square plus y plus 4 whole square minus 16 equals 0 implies we can add 16 both sides. We get x plus 6 whole square plus y plus 4 whole square is equal to 16. This becomes equation of a circle, which is the answer in the A part. Next problem, write the equation in the standard form. Negative 25x square plus 4y square plus 350x minus 56y minus 929 equals 0. So let us club the terms, minus 25x square plus 350x plus 4y square minus 56y minus 929 equals 0. So I can write this as, I can take minus 25 common, x square minus 14x plus 4 common, y square minus 14y minus 929 equals 0. 14 by 2 is 7 and 7 square is 49. Now we'll add 49 inside both the parentheses, but when we'll subtract the term, it will be, 1 will be 49 times 25 and 1 will be 49 times 4, since they are outside the parentheses. 49 times 25, which is 1225, and 49 times 4. 196. So we will have minus 25 times x square minus 14x plus 49 plus 4 times y square minus 14y plus 49 plus 1225 minus 196 minus 929 equals 0. This is plus because this sign is minus here. We have done minus 1225 here. Therefore, to balance, we do plus. Now, this is a minus b whole square formula. A minus b squared is a squared minus 2ab plus b squared. So this is minus 25 times x minus 7 squared plus 4 times y minus 7 squared plus 100 equals 0. Subtracting 100 both sides, we get minus 25 times x minus 7 whole square plus 4 times y minus 7 whole square is equal to minus 100. Dividing by minus 100 both sides, we have minus 25 times x minus 7 whole square by minus 100 plus 4 times y minus 7 squared by minus 100 is equal to 1. Or we can say x minus 7 whole square by 4 minus y minus 7 whole square by 25 is equal to 1, which is the answer in the B part. Next problem. Write the equation in standard form. Minus 50x square minus 8y square plus 600x minus 112y minus 1992 equals 0. So we'll have minus 50x squared plus 600x plus minus 8y squared minus 112y minus 1992 equals 0. So we can take minus 50 common, minus 50 times x square minus 12x minus 8 times y square plus 14y minus 1992 equals 0. So this becomes 12 by 2, 6, 6 square 36. Minus 50 times x square minus 12x plus 36 minus 8 times y square plus 14y plus 49 minus 1992 plus 1800 plus 392 equals 0. 50 times 36 is 1800 and 8 times 49 is 392. So we have minus 50 times x minus 6 whole square minus 8 times y minus 7 whole square plus 200 equals 0. Subtracting 200 both sides, minus 50 times x minus 6 whole square minus 8 times y minus 7 whole square is equal to minus 200. Dividing by minus 200 both sides, minus 50 times x minus 6 whole square by minus 200 minus 8 times y minus 7 whole square by minus 200 is equal to 1. We can say x minus 6 whole square by 4 plus y minus 7. Sorry, this was y plus 7 whole square. I'm sorry. Plus y plus 7 whole square over 25 is equal to 1. Which is the answer in the B part. Sorry, C part. It is y plus 7 whole square. I hope you can practice more problems on changing equations to standard form, another method now. Thank you for watching. Have a great day. Bye bye.